Hey everybody, it's Jennie McGarvey, and I am happy to share with you today a page that I created using the January 2016 Scraptastic Club kit. As you can see, it is a winter-themed kit, and I am creating a page that is not winter-themed. So this week, or this month, I should say, the subscriber challenge was to use a kit in a different way than it was intended. So this kit was obviously intended to be a winter kit. And so I decided to make this a use it for a boy kit. So I took this kit, I went through it, I picked several of my favorite elements, which was super easy because there were a lot of really cute things in it that I had not been able to use because I didn't actually have any winter photos this year. Look at that cut apart, it's gorgeous. When I was pulling out these elements, I decided that my photo wasn't gonna work. As you can see, my son is wearing an orange shirt, and while it's a great photo, I need it to be black and white. So I simply opened the PicTapGo app on my phone, changed the photo to black and white, used the app for my Canon selfie printer, and quickly printed out a black and white version of that photo to go with these papers, which I love with the aqua and the turquoise and the white, and then the little hints of navy blue. It's absolutely perfect. I didn't mention it already, but this kit is called the Hazy Shade of Winter kit, and then also the add-on. I will at the end pull in a few elements from the January This Life Noted add-on. Because this is a winter themed kit, all of the embellishments are sort of winter themed. There's a couple that are not, but mostly they are winter themed. And because I am not doing that, I couldn't really make snowflakes and that kind of stuff work, though I did try to figure out how I could. I am using a sheet of patterned paper. It's white with very faint little polka dots on the back. It's super cute. And this sheet from Pebbles, I absolutely love it. The snowflake side is awesome. And then this stripe side, I love the color. I love the width of the stripes. I knew it was going to be perfect for this page. There's also some pink paisley alphabets in there. They're white cardstock. They're fairly tall, maybe 3 inches tall, and then on the one side they're very shimmery. They're super pretty, and I knew that I wanted to use those to spell out my title as well. So going through the kit, it was a challenge to pull out items that I could use in a diverse way and not have it be winter themed. Now, there were plenty of sequins and there were plenty of label stickers and all kinds of things that were definitely not winter themed. However, they were mostly red and gold, which is totally fine. And had I been doing a different type of page, like maybe I should have done a baseball page with this kit, that would have probably been perfect, right? But because I didn't and I was really sticking to the blue and white theme, I couldn't really use some of those elements. But it's okay because I used the This Life Noted kit, as you'll see in a little while, and the add-on for that, I'm sorry, and just pulled some of those embellishments. And it works in the same theme because that's actually obviously a pocket page kit. Now I'm going to cut apart two of the 3x4 cards in that cut apart sheet. I love this heart card. I'm so excited to get to use it. And then there's one that says chill out with a beautiful blue color, which I'm super excited about. And I love all of that together with that blue and white striped paper. And as you can see, the photo is much, much better now that it's in black and white and you don't have my son's orange shirt just sort of glaring with the rest of the colors. As you can see, there is the chill out card. I love that color. It's awesome. And it's just perfect for a boy page, a dude sort of page. As you can see, those colors in those two cut aparts go perfectly with that blue and white striped paper, which I love. I'm keeping the design of this page really super simple. I'm not going crazy. There actually won't be a ton of embellishment either. Overall, it's a really simple page. Very linear, very line, not at all any mixed media or anything like that. Not that I typically do that anyway, but those are those pink paisley alphabets. I think they're from their Yuletide collection. And I am trying to spell out cool dude. I thought that would be really fun because with those sunglasses, that's sort of the feeling that this invokes. And then with the cool colors on this page, like a cool color palette, you know, I figured cool dude was sort of appropriate for this. However, I get through the entire package and I don't have an extra D, which is okay. It's all right. So I just change it up and I make it cool guy instead. And also works, does the exact same thing I needed it to. I just can't spell out dude, so that's okay. So we'll just have to be patient while I look through all of those alphas in order to spell out cool guy. I had considered masking these alphabets to maybe do a diagonal color at the bottom, maybe using an acrylic paint or something like that. So on the diagonal, maybe putting some washi and then painting the bottom and removing the tape. But I decided that that did not go with the overall theme of this page, which was just really simple, bright, and white. Now, the linear part of it, like the diagonal line, would have been super cool. No pun intended. However, I decided that it was probably best just to leave them white and let the shimmery part of it be the only embellishment here. I also considered using foam dots to pop up the cool, and that also would have been really good, and I think that that could have worked fine with the theme. In the end, I decided to not do that just because I did want to keep the overall design fairly simple. Most of my pages are simple, so it's not like, oh, this is some huge departure or anything like that, but I felt like keeping it, since it's not overly embellished, actually there's hardly any embellishments at all, it would be weird if I kind of went crazy. Side note, I love the back of that paper with the trees and the black and the white. It's absolutely beautiful. Not exactly sure how I would use it. It would be sort of difficult for me. I can't think of any photos that I have that would go with that, but I love it all the same. I actually think it might make a cool divider or dashboard for a planner or something like that where you can really just let the paper shine. That would be very cool. Now, when I'm laying down the title, I am not putting it all in one straight line. The guy will be, but the cool, I kind of varied the baseline for all of those. So some are a little bit taller or shorter than the others, and then just went with that. I liked the way that it kind of mixed things up and made it a little bit crazy, even though it's completely and totally not crazy whatsoever. So what I will do is I will just adhere those down with my ATG gun, which you can see right there. I love using it for bigger items to adhere. It's super sticky and those aren't going anywhere. If you do pull it up right away, you can remove it, but after a while, it's totally not going anywhere and you will ruin whatever you are pulling up. But luckily for me, I don't usually do that. Now here's that This Life Noted add-on that I told you about that I was going to use to embellish, and I feel like it still goes with the theme of using the kit in a different way than it was intended. But before we can break into the kit and use those two embellishments, which is die cuts and chipboard stickers, I need to change the adhesive in my ATG. I can't believe this has never happened to me before while I was filming that I ran out, but today it did. So if you've been nervous about the ATG, you can see it's very, very simple to change. Now, of course, I change it on the weekly basis, so that's why I suppose it's been not too difficult for me to learn how to do it. But as you can see, it's very, very simple. It's not a difficult task at all, and the ATG is super inexpensive and holds really, really well. And as somebody who's been scrapbooking for a very long time, I can tell you not all adhesives are the same, and some of them do lose their stickiness, and you will find things at the bottom of a page protector. So that's what I like the ATG for. I know they're sticking. I know they're not going anywhere over time, and they seem to be holding up very well. Now, just adhering those alphabets down, they're nice and tall and nice and thick, so there's no worries about the adhesive. I don't have to worry that it's going to be poking out and I have to push it over. Not that that usually actually bothers me or anything like that. I just move it out of the way. But it's super simple and not a problem at all. Keeping in mind that I am not doing the cool part in a linear way, I am changing up the baseline for those letters. So now really that's the main portion of the page. The design is pretty much complete. I'll go through the die cuts and look and see if I can find something to go with that. There's a few different things that would work. I'm trying to stick with the black and white or maybe some red elements just because that's where we're really at with this page. It's fairly simple color-wise, obviously design-wise as well. And there are some pinks and yellows and stuff like that in that die cut set. And then I'm going for the same thing in these chipboard stickers. These are a Project Life chipboard sticker. And there are so many awesome ones in here. And I love the colors and I love the designs. And I've only gotten to use a few, but I finally pull one out. It says Real Life, as you can see right over there on the left. And I love how it turns out. I'm going to use the ATG to adhere that circle with the swirl in the center. And then I'm going to get out my foam dots. As I've talked about 100 times before, the ThermoWeb are my favorite. I love the height and the density of the foam. And then use those to pop up the See the Beauty right on top of that red die cut as well. And then I will also pull out a little banner, flag type thing or whatever, in that package of Project Life stickers. And then adhere that right below the cool guy. It's so fun to be able to pick different embellishments that maybe weren't intended to go together or whatever. See, look how cool that is. So now, really, honestly, the page is finished except for just adding a little bit of hand journaling and the date. And then that's it. That's the whole page. So if you enjoyed my video, thank you so much for stopping by. I really do appreciate your time and you watching. If you enjoyed it, please leave me a thumbs up. That lets me know that you like me making videos, and it also lets YouTube know what you like to see. Thank you so much, and make it a great day.